Welcome to A Breath of Fresh Air with Sandy Kaye.
Because it's a beautiful day.
A breath of fresh air.
Beautiful day. Oh, baby, any day that you're gone away. It's a beautiful day.
Thanks so much for hanging out with me today. I'm very grateful for your company. Lots coming up for you as always, including Barry Gibb, Al Stewart and Van Morrison. But first, if you grew up in Australia, you're bound to know this song. It became somewhat of a national anthem as well as a huge hit right around the world.
Sometimes when this place gets kind of empty, sound of their breath fades with the light. I think about the loveless fascination under the Milky Way tonight. Lower the curtain down in Memphis. Lower the curtain down, all right. I got no time for private consultation under the Milky Way tonight. Wish I knew what you were looking for. Might have known what
Under the Milky Way from Sydney band The Church, featuring one Marty Wilson-Piper on guitar. The effervescent Englishman is a self-confessed nerd who has a serious musical pedigree and enough energy to burn. These days, Marty travels solo and spends his time collaborating on various projects. He also offers a successful online musical mentoring program.
Thanks so much for talking with me today, Marty. And you're luxuriating there in Porto in Portugal, are you?
Well, we've moved here to live. We just live here now. It's just home.
Uh-huh.
When I left the X band, I just thought most people in my position, they look for famous people or known people to work with. But I thought it'd be interesting to see if I could find some people who weren't known, who weren't famous, who had ideas and were creative and needed some help, some confidence, some mentoring and somebody with experience to help them. It's exciting.
You've got some new music of your own coming out.
I've just got a brand new record come out. It's called Moat, is the name of the band. It's a collaboration between me and a Swedish friend. He plays in a quite well-known band in Sweden called Weeping Willows, who are actually massive. And we made a record a few years ago, and this is the second album. It's got electric, it's got strings, it's got folky ballad, it's got real drums, it's kind of everything.
The blood on your lips drips, red honey slips into a pool. The lies that you tell corrupt my heart, infect my soul. Like a wave in the dark, the films you play, black and white, the final scene, crying, and you're gone.
The first track we put out from it on the net was track called Gone by Noon, which is quite sort of moody and cinematic. It's almost kind of Bond-like. It could almost be a mellow Bond theme.
Uh-huh.
When we did that track, I mean, I wasn't scared, but I did think it was might be a bit too middle of the road for people who like me. But it's been absolutely the opposite. People are saying, no, it's really Bacharach-esque. And when people start comparing you to Burt Bacharach, that's quite humbling.
You're doing good.
Yeah, you're doing good, yeah.
Well, you've come a long way since the days of the church, haven't you?
When I was in the church, I was also playing for 10 years in All About Eve in England. And I always made solo records and I always did collaborations. And
you love to be busy.
I'm a bit of a workaholic, a musical workaholic.
I can relate to that. You call them the ex-band. Is that like the ex-wife whose name we never mention?
Yeah, well, you know, the ex-band, it's the truth, right?
Yeah. There's a gorgeous little story about how you actually came to play with the ex-band.
The story is, at some point I left Liverpool and moved to London, and I met a girl there, Lucy, who after we'd kind of been dating for about 2 or 3 weeks, I asked her something about her London accent, and she said to me, "I'm not from London, I'm Australian." And I was like, "Oh, really? You're Australian?
How exotic."
I really didn't know the difference between a London accent and an Australian accent. She said, "Let's go to Australia." And me being 21 and willing to do anything for the sense of adventure, I went, "Great, why not? Let's do it." And then she said, "Well, if we got married, it would be easier because of the visas and all that." We got married and we got on a plane and flew to Australia.
Uh-huh.
There was the ex-boyfriend of a friend of Lucy's. He was playing in the band one night and I went along in my tiger skin jacket and my hoop earrings and my tight pants. And I was just looked like the perfect, it didn't matter if I could play guitar.
You were gorgeous, weren't you? You just looked the part.
I just looked the part.
Right. You worked your way up and you hung out with them for 33 years. It's amazing.
You're listening to a chat with Marty Wilson-Piper from The Church.
Marty, which of the songs that The Church did you do like best?
It's out of 25 albums.
Would you have a favourite that you could pinpoint?
It's like there's different eras of music that the band played. On the first album, there was Is This Where You Live, which was always a great song to me because it was very moody.
Have always had a penchant for that moody sound.
You know, I'm the kind of person that walks into a room and if the lights are on, I turn them all off.
Not even down, just off.
Yeah, just off.
And it's not to save electricity.
No, it's not to save electricity. I kind of like lurking in the dark. And I always loved nerds. Nerds are the most underrated people in the world because, first of all, they're always smart, so you've got to love them for that.
Uh-huh.
When I was a kid, I collected stamps.
I did too.
I had my father's, my grandmother's,
yeah.
My mum's.
Do you still have that stamp album?
Yeah, I still have the stamps.
You've still got them. That's awesome. I hear that you're an avid collector of all things.
I am. Yeah, I have like 50,000 albums and 26 lava lamps.
So you classify yourself still as a nerd?
Nerd means educate, right? I like the idea of constant education. I study French every day. Oh, yeah, and watch snooker. That's a nerdy thing as well.
And next projects?
Yeah, we are basking in the glory of the Moat release, but the next thing's coming out. I've just made an album with Jerome Froser from Tangerine Dream. And I've got Sessioneer projects coming out. One called Space Summit, which is with one of Sessioneer Jed from Minneapolis, which I think people are going to really like. I play all the guitars and bass and co-wrote all the songs. As he sat among the trees, don't want to be just focused on one thing. I want to think about things in terms of creativity, you know, working on projects, learning, helping people, playing guitar, being the singer, being the co-songwriter, being the bass player if you want me to be, just having musical relationships with people. That's what I want.
Don't know where you get all that energy from, Marty.
Well, I don't drink. I don't smoke. I'm veggie for 37 years. I swim 3 times a week. You know, I just try and stay alive, really.
He sets an example we could all follow, doesn't he? The Church's Marty Wilson-Piper.
This is A Breath of Fresh Air with Sandy Kaye.
It's a beautiful...